Hello YouTubers, Jim from Ohio here. Wanted to give another quick update on my progress with my DIY solar system. Over the last couple weeks I've done a little bit more work on the battery pack. I do have everything wired up now and just wanted to kind of show my progress. What I've got here, I've got five banks of four each 12 volt batteries. And these are the Valence lithium iron magnesium phosphate batteries, and each of these batteries are 12 volt batteries. And the first thing that I did was add a bus bar and connect the batteries in series. So with these two batteries connected in series, it increases their voltage from 12 volt to 24 volt. And same thing back over here. We've got the bus bar connecting the two of them to create a 24 volt battery bank. And then these cables that are on each side connect the two sets in series. And so I have four batteries still running 24 volt. I did make these cables up on my own. I used a crimper. There's no solder in any of the connections, so I crimped the connector onto each of the cables, and then I attached some shrink wrap or heat shrink tubing to just keep everything nice and safe and secure. And on the negative side, what I've got is an A&L fuse. This is an 80 amp fuse, and so we're coming off of one corner of this battery set into the fuse, and then that goes from the other side of the fuse down into a bus bar that I've got down under here. Got the negative on one side and the positive on the other side. Now on the positive side of the batteries, I've got this red cable that's coming off here, the opposite corner of where the negative is, and that's coming over here, and this is an 80 amp fused breaker, and this allows me to enable or disable any of the five battery banks at any time. So if I want to work on this battery bank, I can simply push the breaker button to take it offline, and it'll be separated or isolated from the rest of the batteries and the rest of my system. So on the other side of the breaker, the positive side comes out and it goes down, and that attaches to the positive bus bar underneath. And I did exactly the same thing with all five of the battery banks. And then from the bus bar, the positive cable goes up, and this is my battery selector switch. So the positive side is plugged into one side, and this is a marine switch. It does allow me to have two battery banks connected at any one time. Now I have all five of these battery banks connected on one side. And what I'll probably do later, I do have some plans of either adding a DIY power wall built with 18650 batteries, or some batteries that are salvaged from a an electric vehicle that has been wrecked. I'm kind of toying between that option instead of the 18650s, but I'll be able to connect a second battery bank over here, and that would allow me to run off of either bank or both of them at the same time. So we go from the positive side here up into the inverter. On the negative side, coming from the bus bar, I've got a 150 amp switch breaker, and what this allows me to do, I can either use this to disconnect the battery bank from the inverter, or this. The reason I added the breaker was it adds some automated protection if I'm not at home and something goes bad. This breaker should trip out at 150 amps. So the negative side goes also up to the inverter. So I do have the batteries online right now, and I still don't have the solar panels connected to the inverter here, but it is powered up being powered by the batteries, and I've got it connected to, if you watch my previous video, you'll know that this is a 40 amp circuit that's tied into my breaker panel, and that feeds power from the breaker panel over to the battery charger unit. I can charge the batteries with either solar power, or I can charge them from the grid in case I have a long period of time with no solar power. This is then connected over to the laptop, and I'm using the watch power software that came with this unit to manage and monitor the batteries. I'm not going to go into this, I'm still learning this, but right now I do have everything set up according to the battery manufacturer's specifications as far as the charging current. I've got set to 20 amps, and it is I can either charge the individual banks one at a time by simply turning off all of the other banks, or I can have them all on at the same time and charge them all up at once. A couple of things on safety. I'm trying to do my best to keep things as professional, not only for the sake of how things look, but just for safety's sake. And that's why I took the extra time to not only crimp the connections, but also put the heat shrink tubing in place, make sure I've got multiple breaker and a fuse on each battery pack. And then another thing I'd like to just throw out there, if you are going to be working around batteries a lot, take the time to get yourself a wrench that's going to be dedicated to the batteries. And this is the end I'll use for tightening all my connections on the batteries, on the fuses, and on my switch breakers. But I took the time to put heat shrink tubing, and I shrunk that. This way, if I'm working on one of the batteries and the wrench slips out of my hand, there's no way for me to short circuit between the two battery posts. I've seen that done before. I've actually done that myself before and had a wrench like this welded between two battery posts, and it's something that can be very dangerous and can actually take your life. So take just a few extra minutes and a few extra dollars, get yourself a dedicated wrench, heat shrink them. I've got three of them here handy if I ever need to do any work on my battery bank. I've got all three size wrenches that will be needed, and I've got all of them safely heat wrapped so that I don't have any accidents. So that's the only update that I have for now. I am still waiting on one more part for this, and then I'll talk about this and get you a wiring diagram for that. I would like to talk a little more in depth on this in an upcoming video to explain what it is, how it works. I know that on some of the previous videos, I've used terminology that has raised questions in the video comments down below. And I think the confusion is I've been using the word grid frequently, and when I use the word grid, I know that we have the commercial grid that comes in from the power company and feeds the house, but I also use the term grid when I'm referring to my my house, the wiring that takes care of my house. This is a grid tie inverter, and it is actually tied into the circuit breaker panel and can backfeed into the grid, or the way that I'm going to have it set up. I'm going to set it up so that it does not do that, but it does feed the circuits in my house at all times. This inverter is not an on-grid inverter. It's not a grid tie inverter. This is an off-grid inverter. Now, I'm going to be setting it up so that it does control several of the circuits in my house all the time. And the way that I'll do that, there is one other part that I'm going to be adding to this, and that's going to be a generator transfer switch that I plan on mounting on the wall in this area right here. That'll be tied into my circuit panel. I'll be able to isolate circuits from here over to the transfer switch, and then this will feed the solar power over to the transfer switch to those circuits that are isolated from my main panel. Now, you can do that with this type of inverter because this is a smart inverter. This inverter will feed power to what I plan on hooking up by either solar power, or if I don't have enough solar, it will supplement the solar with my batteries. If I don't have enough power, either solar power or battery power, to run what I'll have on that transfer switch, that 40 amp circuit that's coming from here will feed this, and this device has an automatic transfer switch built into it, so it can automatically switch from solar power or battery power over to the grid power that'll be fed from this panel over to the inverter, and then up to 2400 watts can then be fed over to the transfer switch that'll be here. I hope that clears up some of the terminology with how I've used the word grid. I know a couple of people mentioned in comments that this device cannot be connected to the grid, and that is absolutely correct. It can't be connected to the commercial grid. However, the grid that I'll be creating in my house with the transfer switch, that's what will be feeding off of this inverter. It'll also allow me to switch my primary circuits or my critical circuits in the case of a power outage situation. I'll be able to switch some of the circuits from here over to this transfer switch. That'll allow me to run my furnace, my well pump, my sump pump, and a few other critical circuits in the house, either by generator or by this device. So when I get that transfer switch and I start hooking things up, that'll be another video that's down the line. But so that's what I've got going on for now. Thanks for watching, thanks for tuning in, and thanks for the comments that are being posted down below. Have a good week, and I'll post another video when I've got something more to post. Take care.